Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today, we are diving deep into the world of neutral density filters, or ND filters, for DJI drones. These little pieces of magic are essential for capturing cinematic footage, especially in bright conditions. I have been experimenting with the DJI ND filter set, the ND16, the ND64, and the Super Dark ND256. Now, each of these filters reduces the amount of light hitting your drone sensor, but they do it in different ways, leading to some pretty distinct results. Today's experiment is straightforward. I took the exact same shot at the same time of the day with each of these filters in the reverse order of their darkness. That's right, we started with the ND256, then moved to the ND64 and finished with the ND16. I wanted to see how drastically the footage changes as we let more and more light in. Let's jump right into the results. First up, we have the footage shot with the ND256 filter. This is the darkest of the bunch, blocking a massive amount of light. As you can see, the overall image is definitely darker. However, pay close attention to the details in the distance. Even with the strong sunlight, we can still make out the features of those buildings and the texture of the landscape. The bright sky is nicely controlled, preventing any major blowouts. So, the ND256 did a fantastic job of taming the bright sunlight and preserving detail in the highlights and distant objects. But, as you saw, the trade-off is an overall darker image. This might require some color correction in post-production to brighten things up. Next up, we have the ND64 filter. This one lets in significantly more light than the ND256. Let's see how it performed in the same scene. Notice the difference immediately. The image is noticeably brighter and has better overall clarity. We are still getting that nice reduction in glare from the sun, preventing those harsh brown-out areas. And while we can still see details in the distance, the image feels much more balanced and natural straight out of the camera. The ND64 seems to strike a really nice balance. We are getting that crucial glare reduction for smooth cinematic shots, but without sacrificing too much overall brightness and clarity. This footage looks great straight out of the drone. Finally, let's take a look at the footage captured with the ND16 filter. This is the lightest of the three, allowing the most light to enter the sensor. well, look at those colors pop. The greens are vibrant and the blues of the sky are rich, and the overall image is bright and cheerful. However, take a look at what's happening when the sun is directly in the frame. We are losing a lot of details in those bright areas, and the distant objects are getting a little bit lost in the glare. The ND16 definitely gives us that bright and punchy look, which can be great for certain situations. But as you can see in this particular scenario with the sun shining directly, it struggled to control the highlights and preserve details in the distance. So there you have it. The ND256 gave us great control over the highlights and preserved decent details, but resulted in darker overall image. The ND64 offered a fantastic balance of glare reduction, brightness and clarity. And the ND16 provided vibrant colors, but struggled with direct sunlight and distant details in this specific scenario. Now, for the big question, which filter do I think is better? Well, it really depends on the situation and the look you're looking for. For this particular bright sunny day where I wanted to maintain detail in the distance and control the highlights, the ND64 is a clear winner for me. It provided the best overall image quality straight out of the drone without sacrificing too much brightness or clarity. If you found this video helpful, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more drone adventure. Thanks for watching, fly safe, and I'll see you in the next video.